one since the 90s.
Oh, Jen, I have to fix this.
No, no, leave it. I have it how I like it.
How you like it? No, 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 Jen, it's infected. If this was a human being, I'd shoot it in the face.
I just want you to install a browser.
That's the browser there. Look at it, that's the browser. Internet Explorer is a browser. Behind the picture of the lady. The lady's not supposed to be there.
She's only there sometimes. But what's the the E? But that's the button for the internet, Roy.
Button for the internet!
Oh, shut up. I'm not a stupid geeky geek.
Jen, you don't need to be a geek to know that you need a browser to access the internet.
Yes, you do, because as soon as you know something like that, it pushes out something important, and before you know it, you're painting little figurines from Lord of the Rings.
You know what, Jen?
Do whatever you want. I don't care. You want to walk around with a laptop from The Exorcist? That's just fine. It's not my problem. Our time is too valuable.
I think the thing I enjoy most about working with students is being able to provide them with real world work opportunities and allow them to see how the work that we do here integrates and works with the campus network. Our students do a whole lot of work here. We train them to do real world projects. They assist in operations. We have them configure pieces of hardware, go onto campus and actually install things. And in other opportunities, they actually integrate directly with other students to be able to solve problems that they have. We teach our student workers all kinds of things. We teach them basic networking skills, basic troubleshooting skills, being able to utilize the scientific method that they learn in classes and apply that to enterprise troubleshooting. We have people call in with problems, and being able to isolate what that problem is and come to a solution quickly and efficiently is one of the key things that we teach our workers here.
And it's sort of like I'm doing like a project on my own that enhances my classroom experience, which is, you know, it's sort of interesting to have that beyond your classroom. I do get a lot of mentoring. They tell me about, like, you know, how to go by a project. They don't say do this in stepwise, but they give you an overview and then where to look at. So it's kind of like a real life experience where your boss would say, okay, do this for me, and then they give you sort of like a layout, and then you can always go back and say, hey, I don't understand this, and then they'll give you, like, you know, overview, more like specifics of that topic.
How am I going to get my grades out of this?
They're not on the disc?
The disc?
Oh, my God. You know, in 3 years, I have never seen you use your computer. This is your dirty little secret, isn't it? You're a physics professor who's computer illiterate.
I am not.
Well, fine, fine. But if you ever need my help, I, an anthropology professor, will teach you, a physics professor, how to open a file with your mouse.
Computer, activate now. Silly me, it's Japanese.
Working with the students, it's been extremely rewarding. When I first started here, we, way back in 1983, we did a lot more, the department did a lot more work, direct work with students. And over the years, we've kind of, at least the areas I've been, have been away from the students, so it's nice to come back and actually work with them, because that's what the university is all about, is the students. It's been nice also to see the reaction of the customers who get a student on the phone. When we start the students on the phone, I actually have them listening to me while I talk, and I will tell the customer that, by the way, Rocky is listening in on the phone today, she's learning about the Solution Center. And everybody has been very excited to hear that there's a student. They say welcome and all of that, and we've seen that general response repeated when the students have been on their own on the phone. So that speaks well of our community overall as well.
And what I really like is that I come across new problems every day, and it's just wonderful trying to get to know how to fix those problems. So yeah, and I also like working with all the wonderful people here.
Almost 90% of what we do here is non-technical. What they need to do is talk to the customers and find out what the customer's problem is. And that means in speaking in the customer's language.
If you agree, Mrs. Patmore.
Certainly, Mrs. Bird. Oh, my Lord, listen to that. It's like the cry of a banshee.
Mr. Carson's telephone is ringing. But isn't someone going to answer it?
I wouldn't touch that thing with a 10-foot pole.
Starting off, I will learn how to work on a team with other people with the same interests as me, so they give me that teamwork. And I will also gain common knowledge that I see is like needed for everyone in the world to know. For example, solving getting rid of viruses on computers, booting and backing up computers, things like that. So just the common knowledge to know what to do to my laptop. And people are scared. Like, they buy something that costs thousands of dollars, they're scared to take the back off to fix like some simple problem. So they want others that's trained to look at it and see.
I think what I enjoy most about working with students is the fact that they're very inquisitive. Students come in, they're very eager to learn. They generally come to us, and it's probably one of their first jobs, so they don't know what an experience like this is, so it's kind of on us to teach them. I really enjoy that part of it, is teaching the students what it's like to work in a real work environment. I think the STaRS program really helps students learn, you know, what it means to actually work in a real work environment. When they, like I said before, when they come to us, this could have been their very first job, and they've never been in any type of work space at all. And some of them, it's like babies coming in, and they really don't know what expectations are. They don't know, you know, what it is to have somebody telling them, you know, you need to do this by a certain time, or these are deadlines. Some of them just don't understand those kinds of things and how important they are and what expectations are. So yes, I really do think the STaRS program helps.
Computers, we troubleshoot different technologies. So coming from, you know, repairing an operating system that breaks, pulling out hard drives, backing up data, as well as troubleshooting printers or the printing scripts, and also going to people's dorms or like the on-campus apartments to help with the TV issues or Wi-Fi signal. So when I started as a freshman, I looked up to the older techs and the veterans for, you know, learning how to do pretty much everything. And even though I had some technical background coming into it, I didn't know how to fix probably 5% of problems. And I learned it all on the job, and that was all because of the older techs. And now I try to provide the same role for the new guys. Someone's training right now, and you have to go through show them the ropes and how to approach different problems.
Yeah, I wanna leave behind a legacy of stellar service. I want to make sure that everyone that comes into here working with us understands that we are the best at what we do. We kill it every single day, and we don't want to drop that standard. We want to continue raising the bar. We want to make sure that everyone is doing the best work they can possibly do. And that's what I want to leave behind.
It kind of runs the gambit between tech and administrative support, you know, from one extreme to the other. Kwame's been on several projects, you know, from SharePoint support, technical support, actually hands-on working with the equipment, and even going out in the field and some rapport building. He's particularly good at that.
Currently, I'm working on a special project to virtualize and preserve crucial technologies that are no longer in mainstream production. Yeah, I think the STaRS program is wonderful. That's how I found my job, and also they were willing to help me when I needed it most. So I definitely recommend it to any student at WashU.